Sex Trafficking by Jordan, Crystal, and Andy. Meet Q. Q lives in Savay Pak, a poor town in Cambodia. Her parents are deep in debt, like many other families in this town, surviving on $1 or $2 a day supporting her sick father and many other siblings. When Q was 12, her mother sold her virginity to a man. She was locked in a hotel for 2 days where a man raped her. Following this, she moved to another location where she was raped by 3 to 6 men a day. Q was then lucky enough to have been rescued by a Catholic group. Unlike Q, many young Cambodian women are sold into sex slavery, sometimes by their parents, or they are tricked by traffickers, where they are offered good jobs as waitresses in larger cities that have wages that can support their family. Thereafter, they are taken to brothels where they are forced to have sex with clients. If they refuse, they suffer physical abuse and torture. In brothels, they are property and profit, no longer human beings. Even when some girls manage to escape from their brothels, they may not be accepted back. This modern buying, selling, and transporting of humans is called trafficking. In other words, it's modern-day slavery. An estimate of 1.2 million children are trafficked every year. 43% of these victims are used for sexual exploitation. In 2010, majority of the victims of sex trafficking in Cambodia were 13 to 17 years old. Reports of much younger, even 2, have been filed. 1 in 150 people in Cambodia are commercial sex workers. 1 out of 40 children will be trafficked in Cambodia. Sex trafficking is prevalent in all countries of different economies. However, Cambodia is a known hub of sex trafficking, particularly in children. Cambodia has a rare, disturbing history. From 1957 to 79, their dictator, Pol Pot, murdered 2 million people, men, women, and children. Cambodia was cleansed of all religious, educational, and social structures. This left a lack of Buddhist or any kind of ethical structures. Today, Cambodia's police is corrupt. Oftentimes, brothel owners make deals with local police, making it near impossible for these brothels to get shut down. Cambodia's violent history can be attributed to one of the reasons as to why the police system in Cambodia is so corrupt. A common Cambodian saying, "Men are like gold and women are like cloth," represents the patriarchal views of Cambodians that men can be used many times and maintain their value, but women can only be used once. Thereafter, they will be considered dirty and worthless. This belief has led parents and families to justify their decision to sell their daughters to brothels. Another large contributing factor is the economy. Poverty is a national problem. Initially, globalization had brought in jobs in the garment and tourist industry, but then when the global financial crisis hit, thousands of jobs were lost. This loss left families starving and desperate for relief, causing people to sell the bodies of young women for money. Globalization has also brought ashore a demand for sex prostitutes. In 1991, the demand for sex workers increased with the arrival of UN peacekeepers. And from there on, the demand has been sustained and increased with pedophiles across the globe brought to Cambodia for sex tourism. The greater the demand becomes, the more young innocent women it will take to supply. The way these young women are treated by sexual abuse, torture, and emotional abuse must be stopped. As people of the 21st century, we cannot allow for slavery to persist. This issue directly affects everyone because sex trafficking acts as a catalyst for the spreading of HIV. This contagious virus kills hundreds of thousands and could come into contact with you or someone you care about. To solve this problem, Cambodia first needs to be educated on the value of women and the dangers of HIV. Education needs to be offered to girls so they can provide for their families in ways that do not involve selling their body. And international pressure needs to be put on Cambodia to crack down on the sex trafficking industry. Together, we can end sex trafficking in Cambodia and everywhere.
If you or someone you know are victims of human trafficking in the United States, you can call the National Human Trafficking Resource Center at 1-888-373-7888. And to help donate to victims of human trafficking, you can go to www.humantrafficking.org/combattrafficking. Thank you.